Citroen says we are known for having big-ass towers.
That's true. We're known for the CN Tower, at once the tallest freestanding building in the world. No longer, though. Dubai has that dubious honor now.
Damn it, Dubai. Always one-upping
us. Did you see how I said dubious after I said Dubai?
Dubious Dubai? Did you notice?
Dubious W Dubai.
All right. So we are in game. The map is...
It is going to be...
Daybreak. It's Daybreak. In the top right-hand corner is our Red Terran, up 1-0 in this best-of-three matchup. This is the loser's bracket. He needs to keep winning for a chance at the finals. Root Massa.
All right, and his opponent spawning in the opposite side, the bottom left-hand corner of Daybreak. It is going to be our purple Protoss, Amur.
Le Amour. The lovely Protoss. I've nicknamed him the lovely, so lovely. Protoss. So that's good, huh?
That's pretty good.
That is pretty good.
Not bad. Not bad.
Exion, though. I don't know.
Chat's awesome.
Shawarma. Poutine. Yeah, Poutine's more of a Quebec area, though. I like what you're thinking. I understand it. But no. We gotta let the Montreal people have their poutine and Montreal smoked meat. We gotta be something, though. Somebody should invent something that Toronto will be known for.
It was like, it's like the Toronto food.
What about Ed's? Like. Is Ed's just Toronto?
Eggs?
Ed's. You know the ice cream place? Does its own ice cream, Ed's?
Can you take me?
No. Why Honest not? Ed. Honest Ed, but that's not fun.
Why won't you take me to Ed's? Anyways, so. Back to this game. Enough about the food. Some sneaky stuff going on over here. Massa is doing a very classic Massa move. He's going to be putting down a barracks, but look at this
is
probe.
Is it going
to
be this scouted?
This Sixth Sense probe is going to be able to... Nope.
Just out of range, scouting it. He did have the presence of mind to go around saying, maybe there's some cheese play, but not enough to find out that there actually was a proxy Rax.
This is... Oh, this is like when you're congratulating someone, you're like, man, you did such a good job, and then they just screw up right when you're congratulating them. That's what that probe did. He was doing the right thing, and then he messed it up.
Well, he didn't mess it up, it's just that Massa really played it well. He obviously hid that in a place that That's is true. Not often seen. Massa's obviously very good at that. He studies replays, no doubt about it. He knows what players typically do. But now, you can see that Amor rallied his unit just to the top of the ramp, and now he's like, wait a second, there's a hole here? He's got to know something is up. Immediately, his heart sinks and realizes it is a proxy of some sort. What is he going to be able to do? It takes so long just to produce anything in a Protoss army.
He's looking. He wants to be sure. He's checking the whole base. You know, doesn't want to overcommit to any sort of crazy defense if it was just, you know, placed at the thing of his base. But this proxy isn't. It is actually at his third. And now, getting Marauders with that concussive shell, there's going to be another Marauder concussive shell push going on.
StarCraft 2 is a game of seconds, is a game of inches, of centimeters, of millimeters. We are in Canada, we use that measurement. Every little bit counts, so needing to scout your opponent and being able to identify what you're dealing with and react exactly accordingly, not overreacting, is what you need to do at this high level play.
Exactly, and here comes the first Zealot out trying to chase that... SCV away, but the two Marauders now almost getting ready to pop. Concussive Shell is going to be finished, so once it attacks them, it's going to be two Marauders, an SCV against a Zealot and a Stalker, and I think every single time the Marauder and the SCV will win.
Might need a sentry just to prevent this army from just pushing up and GGing right here. These are the type of games where you break your keyboards over. These are the frustrating losses where you lose only 5 minutes into the game. At least that's how I lose. So the bunker is going down right at the bottom of the ramp. We'll be able to put a hard contain on that Protoss army. It'll be a while before he's able to bust out. Even though he does have a warp prism, or sorry, does have a pylon out for some proxy play if he so chooses. But now the Marauder numbers are getting silly.
Yep, so there's three Marauders up right now. And here comes the fight at the front of the ramp. Look at those Marauders. Going to do a lot of damage to that Zealot, but you know, Zealots are so tanky against Marauders. Marauder's going to retreat into the bunker there. One Stalker does go down. One more Stalker getting cut around, and this Zealot is trying to do so much damage to this Marauder, but he's not going to be able to get him. Probe's going to get him, but there goes down the Stalker. Now, with no range damage, this Marauder has free range. He's going to try to get his way to that bunker, now he's just going to be able to kite these melee units all day. Or melee. Indeed. Is it melee or melee? What do you say?
I think it's melee. Yeah. So now these Marauders are low on health. And now the Stalker isn't going to be able to take down one of the Marauders. Luckily, is going to be able to hurt the other one. Maybe not finish it off before it gets inside of the bunker. This full health Marauder now comes out and represents a huge danger with those concussive shells. And still more Marauders coming, streaming in. Those big brothers. Looming danger.
I'm not too sure. Right now, he's trying to research Stim at the tech lab of his proxy barracks. But you know, if Protoss is able to bust down this ramp, he can easily take that out and delay Stim even more. Nice force field there.
Oh no.
going to be able to get that Stalker, and now these sentries are going to chase this Marauder. This Marauder's going to run away into the base, get a nice scout off at least, and see what's going on. He does see the three warp gates, he sees another one coming, and it looks like it's going to be some sort of four gate play.
God, Marauders should be so much slower. Look how big they are. Why are they so fast?
Hup,
hup, hup, hup,
I'm going to get away.
More Marauders joining the forces, putting some pot shots on these warp gates.
Oh, no.
These sentries might be able to block them out if they're clever, but to realize that they can actually DPS them down in time. And now two Marauders in a bunker at the bottom of the ramp, preventing any sort of expo. And now with the salvage, we'll be able to recoup a lot of those minerals.
So Marauders going back to base now. You can see the starport and also a missile turret coming down for Rootmaster. Just being sure, he wants to make sure he's not going to get killed by anything silly like Dark Templars or whatnot. And here comes the push. It's going to be, this seems like a pretty weak force. Four sentries and only three zealots. I don't know if this is going to do too much damage.
And absolutely bypassing the fact that he had a proxy Rax, maybe realizing that he would rather just push than destroy the proxy capabilities.
Stalkers.
He might be able to kill at least one of these Marauders by cutting them off, and he is trying to focus down the units. Those the Stalkers do kill one from full health. They can easily just go in there and kill one more, but decide to wait for one more Zealot to try to tank as much of the damage as possible. These Marauders are trying to meet up with their Marauder brother.
Goodness.
And now it looks like Amor is going to be able to put some aggression on Massa. He's completely separated the Marauders from their base, and one Marauder is so low that he doesn't even want to be in the front. There are still a number of Marines inside the base of Rootmaster, and the Guardian Shield has been popped. He's going to have to bust down this supply depot wall, and will he be able to do it?
I think Amor is going to be able to do it. With the Guardian Shield up, the Marines are going to do any damage at all, but oh no, Guardian Shield does go down. Nice force move there, keeping up all the SCVs away from this Protoss army, but now from the back, here come the Marauders. They want revenge. They're shooting
one
a Zealot,
down.
Though, but down they go,
and my goodness.
Has Amor done it?
And now Massa is not mining at all. The force field is good to block off at least half of those SCVs. All these SCVs are just getting mowed down by all these units that Amor has in the base. More Zealots still to come and still just ripping apart on these SCVs. A few Marines in the back are being healed, trying to do as much DPS as possible, trying to kill these ranged units. The Stalkers need to focus down the Marines and get rid of that DPS. And the control is good. One more SCV is really trying to kill that one set Stalker. More Stalkers come into the battle. They will be able to outrange those Marines coming out as quickly as they possibly can. 28 workers killed by Amor.
And that was basically all the workers Massa had, so Amor has done it.
That requires a slow clap.